بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our fasts, accept our prayers, accept our du'as, accept our recitation of the Qur'an, and allow us all to continue to benefit and grow in this blessed month of Ramadan. Inshallah, tonight we are listening to the 10th juz of the Quran, which covers half of Surah Anfal, the latter half, and most of Surah Tawbah. And I wanted to reflect a little on Surah Al-Anfal. Surah Al-Anfal covers the Battle of Badr. It talks about the incident of Badr, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted a momentous victory to the believers, a small group of believers against a very large and well-equipped enemy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the incidents in that battle and gives admonitions and advice to the believers with regards to factors that lead to success. And it's interesting, if you think about it, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not set up this first confrontation between the Muslims and the disbelievers, between the Prophet ﷺ and the Sahaba and the disbelievers of Mecca, in a way that was stacked in with the odds stacked in the favor of the Muslims. From the outside, it appeared that the Muslims were at a very severe disadvantage. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them a victory, a huge victory, and called it Yawm al-Furqan, the day of criterion, the day of decision, that decisive day that set the tone from there on, that Islam was here to be a force that would last until the end of time. But the tone in the surah is not a tone of bragging, of boasting, of saying, oh, we were so victorious. Rather, the Quran speaks from above. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking to the Muslims here and reminding them of His blessings upon them, and giving them instructions about how they are to live their lives, both individually and collectively, to secure His support and His assistance at all times. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins the surah, Surah Al-Anfal, and this portion we read yesterday, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the personal qualities of the believers. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. The believers are such that when Allah is mentioned in their presence, their hearts tremble. Their hearts are filled with awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with love and with reverence of Him. And the more a person gets to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more a person's awareness of Him increases, the more a person's awe of Him increases, the more one is conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the more one wants to do things that are in obedience to His commands, and stay away from things that would bring His displeasure. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. And when His revelations are recited upon them, their iman increases, their faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases. As they grow through the Qur'an, and as we are going through the Qur'an in this month of Ramadan, and we are exposing ourselves more to this light, to this source of life, the spiritual life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us through the Qur'an, then we should feel our iman increasing, our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increasing. وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And upon their Lord, they place their trust. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. They are the ones who establish salah, and from that which we have given them, they spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Later, in the passage that begins in the beginning of the 10th juz, which we are listening to today, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds the believers that when they are facing a difficulty, a challenge, an external enemy, how are they to conduct themselves in order to seek that and attain that success and assistance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا لَقِيتُمْ فِئَةً فَثْبُتُوا وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Oh, you who have believed, when you face an enemy, when you face an external threat, then stand firm and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly. so that you may be victorious. Have this firmness, this steadfastness, this confidence that comes from one's faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that stems from one's yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that stems from one's certainty that this deen is a deen of truth, that when I am doing things to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assist and provide victory and support. And as an ummah nowadays, sometimes, you know, when we look at the media, when we look at different things, we see so much negativity. We are inundated with all this negative news. And we, you know, it's easy for someone to become despondent and lose that confidence in this deen. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us so much. We are the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his most beloved messenger. We have the Quran with us, the final revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we witness it every Ramadan, where we witness the recitation of the Quran, unchanged word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have all of these great things for us, and we have to build that confidence within ourselves of the truth of our deen, of the fact that if we were to stick to our deen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's victory will come and his assistance will be there. And we have to impart this confidence into our next generation by teaching them the beautiful teachings of our deen and connecting them with the heroes of our past and of our present, both living and those who have gone before us. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا لَقِيْتُمْ فِئَةً فَاثْبُتُوا وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in abundance. Do abundant dhikr. Always have your tongues and your heart connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially in times of difficulty, especially in times of adversity, especially when facing a challenge. Draw your strength from connecting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's remembrance provides that tranquility, provides that firmness of heart, provides that confidence and that stability that one needs to overcome difficult circumstances and difficult situations. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in another place in the Quran, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, that the believers are those whose hearts become content, who find sakina, who find itmi'nan, who find contentment and relaxation with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. With the remembrance of Allah, do hearts find peace and contentment and rest. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues and he says the second piece of advice, وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. And obey Allah and His Messenger in all circumstances, and especially in situations when you're facing a difficulty, a challenge, turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obey Allah and His Messenger. Look for guidance in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And do not quarrel and dispute amongst yourselves. Don't start fighting amongst yourselves. Unity and being together is fundamental to being successful as a community, as a family, and as a community. At every level of our lives, we have to be united. And it's very common and it's very easy, it's natural to have differences of opinion, but we have to make sure that they're kept within boundaries, within appropriate limits, and that we don't get carried away with those differences, and we don't let our egos get the better of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us later in this surah, one of the favors of his upon the Sahaba was, وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ لَوْ أَنْفَقْتَ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ. That when the Prophet ﷺ came to Medina and to the Arabs of his time, they were very disunited. They had huge quarrels and fights and long-running disputes amongst each other. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought them together. The only thing that was able to unite them was the banner of Islam, was their obedience to Allah and His Messenger, was uniting under this common theme of obeying Allah and His Messenger. And this brought them together. So be united and be together in all of your efforts. Otherwise, what will happen? فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. If you were to quarrel and fight amongst each other, then you will lose your strength, and you will lose in all of your affairs. وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. And be patient and be steadfast. Verily, Allah is with those who are patient. Sometimes the victory is not immediate. Sometimes it takes time. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's assistance will come, but it sometimes takes time. And so have that patience, have that steadfastness. And then finally, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ بَطَرًا وَرِئَاءَ النَّاسِ وَيَصُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And do not be like those who came out of their homes full of conceit, showing off to people, arrogant, pompous, you know, bragging to everybody around them, thinking that they have everything in their hand, that they are in control of everything. Don't be like those people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us here of the disbelievers on the day of Badr. They came out of their homes very arrogant, very cocky, very, you know, proud of themselves, confident within their, because of their own material possessions and their own material capabilities, thinking that they have everything in control. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us that don't be like them. Be those who are humble before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be steadfast, be confident in your deen, but always be humble yourselves before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's victory and assistance come your way. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us both the personal qualities described in the surah of those who are connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times, whose hearts are attached to Allah, whose hearts are attached to the recitation of His book, who respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's call whenever He calls them. And may He grant our communities this unity, this steadfastness, this remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all of our circumstances, especially when we are facing the different challenges that we face. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all tawfiq and hidayah. Wa sallallahu wa sallim wa barik ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.